Hello, and welcome to this overview and demonstration of ASHA's National Outcomes Measurement System, or NOMS, a data collection and reporting tool designed to illustrate the value of speech, language pathology, and audiology services. Today, we will be highlighting the latest version of the NOMS SLP Healthcare Registry and give you a preview of the online data reports each clinician has access to when they log in as a NOMS participant. These reports are interactive dashboards that compare your patient data to the national benchmarks. As you know, benchmarking is a powerful tool that allows you to get a detailed comparison of your patients and the services you provide compared to a national standard. This information can help you and your organization improve the quality of your care and demonstrate the effectiveness of your services. So let's now log into the NOMS system and take a look. When you first log into NOMS, you will be taken to your own personal dashboard, which provides you with a quick snapshot of the progress your patients make in the top functional communication and swallowing domains. You can use the drop-down menu to change the functional communication measure, or use the arrow on the right. Your dashboard is the hub for entering data and running reports using this left-hand menu. From here, you can access your patient records, see information about users and facilities, and access and view your data reports. Let's now walk through running a report in NOMS for this clinician. To start, you would fill in the criteria with the time period and the facility or facilities which you would like to include in your reports. As you can see, there are some default criteria which you can select from the drop-down list, or you can start by putting in a custom date. So let's go ahead and do that. One important note is that the system allows you to generate reports that include data from withdrawn facilities. In this case, we are going to select all facilities and click the Run Report button to generate a report that includes all patients that were discharged from NOMS during this selected time period. A couple of things to point out before diving into the data. At the top of each report will be the default name, Outcomes Report with today's date. You'll also see the report criteria. You can click on the icon pencil to edit your report name and click on the report link for more detailed information. You can toggle between a graphical and tabular view of your reports by clicking on these two icons. And you can save, schedule, download, and print reports using these buttons to the right. More information on how these features and enhancements work can be found in the report user guide that each clinician has access to. Now let's get into the data. Each report is broken down into five sections or tabs. These tabs can be used to navigate to various pages of your report. Each page has a series of interactive widgets in the forms of graphs, cards, or tables. So, for example, the Patient Characteristics tab has widgets for age, gender, race, ethnicity, and diagnoses. If you go to the Service Delivery tab, you will see widgets for treatment setting, length of stay, and treatment sessions per week, as well as some other service delivery variables. The Functional Communication Measures tab has widgets for average change in percent functionality, progress by severity, and information about home program completion. The Patient Reported Outcomes tab has widgets for self-assessed progress and treatment satisfaction. And finally, the Treatment Aims and Targets tab has information about what has been addressed in treatment. Across all pages and tabs, your reports are divided into three levels of data. One for the facility or facilities you selected when generating your report, one for your organization as a whole, if applicable, and one for the national benchmarks. Your report also has filters in the left menu to refine your results, to analyze specific patient populations, and to perform further risk adjustments. Now let's take a look and see how you might use some of these filters on the service delivery page. Many of these treatment parameters, such as setting, episode duration, and number of visits, are important considerations when examining an organization's overall performance. For example, your hospital administrator may use length of stay in SLP treatment as a performance indicator for hospital efficiency. In the length of stay widget, we see that this organization's length of stay in SLP treatment is roughly 10 days more than the national benchmark of 62.7 days. When you see differences like these, you may want to filter your reports by treatment setting or other service delivery or patient variables to limit your comparisons to patients with a similar case mix nationally. For example, if we filter this report by the current treatment setting of inpatient rehab, which is the setting this clinician provides services in, we see the large difference in length of stay disappear. Now, this organization's length of stay in SLP services is shorter than the national benchmark of 20.9 days. The filters you choose will carry over to each page or table in your NOMS report and will be displayed at the top of your report. So, for example, when I go to the FCM tab, I am now only seeing data for patients receiving SLP services in inpatient settings. As I add additional filters, my data will change within and across the pages of my reports. While we are on this page, let's take a look at functional progress by FCMs, one of the key outcome measures used in NOMS. In this tab, you will see information about the amount of progress patients make after SLP treatment. When you first click on the tab, you will see the results for one FCM at a time. The cognition FCM is displayed by default. To view other FCMs, use the FCM selector box in the upper right-hand corner. The first widget in this section, Functional Progress, starts with broad information about progress and provides average gains in functionality for the selected FCM cognition. For example, here you see that on average, this organization's patients made a 20.9% gain in functionality after SLP treatment compared to the national average of 25%. While positive change in functionality reflects improvement and negative change in functionality reflects worsening of condition, it is important to note that there is no single expected amount of change. Average change in functionality is likely to be affected by several factors, including treatment setting, time post-onset, age, medical diagnoses, amount of treatment, and other variables. Be sure to use the filters on the left menu to account for these factors and use the national benchmarks to provide a reasonable proxy for amount of change. As you move down the page, you will get more detailed information about the constructs or the aspects that contribute to overall level of functionality in a selected FCM. Other widgets include progress by functional status at admission, progress by service delivery model, progress by amount of treatment, and information about completion of a home program. These data can be powerful when answering questions from consumers and payers about prognosis, expected outcomes, and how much treatment will be needed to show functional progress. Additionally, the patient-reported outcome section in NOMS can help gauge treatment success, inform consumer choice, and be used when developing quality improvement initiatives and organizational marketing efforts. Finally, the treatment aims and targets section of your report can help describe what occurred during the episode of care to better understand your organization's treatment patterns, identify additional treatment options, and determine areas in need of further clinical training. I hope you enjoyed this quick overview of NOMS and learning about the data reports you will receive in exchange for participation. As always, if you have any questions or are interested in finding out more information, reach out to us at noms@asha.org.